These are just some of the hundreds of thousands of federal employees who will not get paid today. The rallies held on Thursday highlighted the collective personal frustrations boiling over as the partial government shutdown made history as the longest ever, entering its 21st day Friday. Newly elected Phil M. California Congressman T.J. Cox joined the rally in Washington, D.C. in solidarity with the affected federal workers. He asked the House Administrative Officer to withhold his pay until the shutdown ends.
I'm marching for the 250 prison workers in Mendota who are at this moment, you know, driving to work. They're going to put their lives on the line and their efforts are going to go uncompensated. I'm marching for the 800,000 federal workers who are being asked to work without pay. They're being forced to work without pay. They can't pay rent, they can't make their mortgage, they can't put food on the table. They're being asked to survive on grit alone.
Cox was among the 240 lawmakers who voted on Friday in the House of Representatives to end the shutdown at some federal agencies, including the Interior Department and the Environmental Protection Agency. But Republican Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell said that he would not bring any House passed legislation to the Senate floor for a vote without the border wall funding. That leaves these frustrated workers with no answer on when they can go back to work or when they will get their next paycheck. Lawmakers have failed to fund 9 departments, or about a quarter of the government, as President Donald Trump continues to demand more than $5 billion to fund his border wall.
I think we should open up government to have a discussion on the best way to secure our borders.
House Speaker Nancy Pelosi made the comment on Friday during a photo op with fellow Democrats that included Phil M. Congressman Bobby Scott of Virginia, who also voted on the bill to end the shutdown. Meanwhile, one bit of good news on Friday, both chambers passed a bill that guarantees back pay to federal workers affected by the shutdown. The bill now goes to the president's desk. The vice president delivered the news to Customs and Border Patrol agents who have been showing up to work without pay.
The House of Representatives passed legislation that will ensure that all the dedicated professionals at Customs and Border Protection and all of the agencies affected by this shutdown will be paid in full when the government reopens. Your families will get your paychecks.
After 2 weeks of no pay, some workers have applied for loans or have taken second jobs. Meanwhile, the effects of the shutdown are now impacting more than just the workers and their families. Miami International Airport announced on Friday that it will close an airport terminal early over the next few days because unpaid security officers have been calling out. Len Amadin Thornhill, ABS-CBN News.